In this screencast, I'll show you how to make a very simple type of user form using VBA. So the first thing, because we are going to use VBA, we have to make sure we're on the Developer tab. And then we go into Visual Basic, which is our VBA environment. So we go to Insert, User Form, and up comes this user form that we're going to work with. And I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. One thing that you should notice is you cannot move the user form. It will stay fixed to this area. So we're going to make a simple user form. We're going to have one text box and one label. We'll also have two command buttons, a go button and a quit button. So the first thing we want to do is rename this form. We can call it user form 1 in our code, but I like to give it a name that makes sense. So here I'm going to call it test form. And notice up here that that's its new name. In addition, let's change this caption right here and let's just call this components. Now we've set up the user form. Now we're going to use the toolbox to put in our labels and our text box. So over here is a toolbox, and if you notice, each one of them has a different, what they call, control, and we're going to start by using the label one. So what that does is it creates on your user form a label, and we don't need to change the name because we're never going to use this in our code, but let's go down here and change the caption. And what we're going to call this is component. You can see that the caption has changed. That's a little small for my taste. So let's go down here to font, click on this, and you'll see that all the font properties you could want are there. So let's change the size to 16 and say OK. And there we have a component label. The next thing we're going to want to do is put in a text box. And the text box is where you get your values off the user form. So we click on text box and we make one whatever size we want to. And now this is something that you're going to want to change the name, because this is something you'll use in the code. So let's call this component, and it has no caption. We can just leave it the way it is. One thing you should always do before testing out a user form is put a quit button. If you don't do that, you're never going to be able to get out of the user form without having to crash Excel. So if you notice right here, we have what's known as command buttons. We'll put that there and we're going to name it, not surprisingly, quit. And we're going to change the caption to say quit. And let's again change the font. Let's make it italicized or oblique. Make it size 16. Okay, now we have a quit button. So what do we next need? We need a command button that will allow us to run a program from this user form. So we put in another command button, and we're going to call this command button go, and we're going to change the caption so that it says go, like that. And now let's change the font. Let's make this a good old 18 size. All right, so now we have our user form, but we have nothing for it to do. That's where we use these command buttons. Once we double click on them, like this, what you'll notice is you have an area to write a program or some lines of code. So we're going to make this very simple. What we're going to do is assign a variable a, and we're going to have that equal to component, which was the name of our text box, dot text. And just to make sure it works, we're going to say message box A. So what this program should do is take whatever we put in the component text box and then put out a message box that gives whatever we put there. All right, now let's go back to our user form over here, and we double click there. And now let's put a program for code for our quit button. And basically, all we want to do there is when we click the quit button, have the user form go away. And the code for that is unload and then the name of your user form. And the user form we have is what we named test form. So now we're ready to go. However, how do we run this program? In order to do that, we have to insert a module. And here we have to call it something. So we'll just call it sub show form. This module will allow us to show the user form to the user. And the command for that is the name of the user form dot show. All right, so we have our user form, we have our module. How is the user going to be able to access that? And the answer is we go back to our Excel environment, Alt F11, which is what I use, and we insert some kind of shape. And I'll just put a circle here. If you recall, and I showed you from a previous screencast, if you right-click on the shape and go to Assign Macro, you'll see that there is our Show Form macro, and we're going to assign it to that. Let's see what happens when we run it. We click on our button, and look, up comes the user form. And this one we can move around. And let's just put in the number 5 and say go. And we get our message box that shows us 5. So this is just the first step in making a user form. In another screencast, I'll show you how to get rid of the user form and make it a little bit more complex. So notice we hit quit and the user form goes away.